Welcome to all the great viewers here watching these videos and considering what's being said here. Very fortunate for all of us. Also, a great big thank you to the compassionate ones who are actually getting this information, getting it here and getting it out to the world. I'm certainly being helped. There's no question about it. I was helped this morning to unprecedented extent, actually. The awareness of the language of the Alchemy of Ascension basically came to me this morning as a result of really putting a huge push on during the Super Bowl time, both Saturday and Sunday. Did a tremendous amount of taping and focus on getting that information out, and I didn't see it spend the slightest bit of attention to the Super Bowl. So I woke up this morning about 4:30 in the morning and began working, and I just suddenly, these new techniques suddenly arose in my mind, and I understood them, and I apply them. I've been doing it all day, and I realized this is the Alchemy of Ascension. So this is an incredibly fortuitous situation, and I can guarantee you that behind the scenes there's a great intelligence at work. And I believe that certainly part of what's taking place comes from Longchenpa, who is the one that gave me the boost with understanding pure spaciousness, the experience of spaciousness. This is an incredible technique to get to that spaciousness. So I really believe Longchenpa is helping us out. That this is a supremely compassionate, supremely awakened one who cares about the situation. The situation is a crisis in this world. There is no doubt about it, and that's why I'm imploring everybody to actually try your very best and then a little bit more. Because once the crisis comes, it's going to be a lot of trouble to get started. You better have momentum before the crisis in this world occurs. It's already a severe crisis, but it's going to be compounded at some point. You can bet on that. Longchenpa would not be pushing it, saying, hey, you need the Alchemy of Ascension. You need to understand Ascension. I understand Ascension now, I really do. I understand the alchemy of it. It just happened like that, and it's just, okay, I get it. Basically, what I was told, very simple. This is now. Now. To the average, you know, our average intellect, what are you talking about? All these kind of pithy sayings that gurus have used, I understand them now. This is now, as it is. This is as it is, as it is. Car, as it is. Day, as it is. Life, as it is. Talk, as it is. Person, as it is. Tree, as it is. This tree is now. This day is now. This sky is now. This sun is now. This video is now. Okay, this world is now. World as it is. Life as it is. Sun as it is. Cosmos as it is. Universe as it is. Dirt as it is. Rock as it is. Okay, all day long I've been using these techniques. The two, as it is. And I've been keeping them in the singular. I've tried the plural. It doesn't seem to work as well. So what do you do when there's a bunch of trees? You say, tree space as it is. Tree space as it is. House space as it is. Our single house, this house is now. Okay. This house space is now. As you see a whole bunch of houses. Or you can say, this housing is now. This treeing. Turn it into a verb. This is a bunch of trees. Say, this treeing is now. Or even a single tree. This treeing is now. Or this tree is now. Various ways. You can try. And today I just worked on all this to see what works better. I found singular works better. This forest is now. This mountain is now. This mountain range is now. This mountain range is now. Mountain range as it is. So this is a different way of using language, isn't it? I understand the technique. I understand what's going on. I really do. And it's easy to explain, but to really embrace it is a whole different level, actually. But I'm telling everyone, sharing with everyone, this is the Alchemy of Ascension. and you need to do it. You need to practice. This is the higher technique now, off of the base technique of, I don't have a world problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a person problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a princess problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a Shakti problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an accident problem, I have a continuity problem. Only I have one problem, and that's the continuity problem. I have no other problem. Continuity problem is the only problem that I have. This is the root of the practice, actually. It's the root of the practice. It begins to transfer your mind over to the one issue and be able to focus on one issue. Once you do that, and when your mind starts bringing up stuff, say, no value there, no value there, no value there, as it brings up stories and stuff, no value. I don't have a daily problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a weather problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a drought problem. I have a continuity problem. Whatever it is, you've got to practice that first. And once you get really good at that, what happens then, the next steps arise and you say, this is now. So what is, we say, this is now. This tree is now. What is now, actually? What is now is pure spaciousness is now. When we say, you know, Eckhart Tolle said, the power of now. What, I don't know exactly what he's referring to, but I know what I'm referring to when I say now. It means pure spaciousness. Because that is always now. It's timeless. Because its everywhereness is timeless, right? It's already present. Already present. Okay, so there's this pure presence. Pure presence is now. So this is now, right? This is now. Suchness, this is now. This is now. This is now. This light is now. This evening is now. Meaning, it's pure spaciousness, really. What you're saying is, everything that's arising arises in pure spaciousness. This tree is now. Because what we've done is basically we have tried to turn things upside down and backwards, and we are saying that pure spaciousness needs permission from form in order to be. That is the position that this world and the ego, etc., takes. That pure spaciousness has to get our permission, the permission of form, in other words, permission of form to exist, to be. Totally insane, totally upside down. So that's what we have to turn around. That is the belief system that we have. We need to exchange this belief system for the right belief system, which pure spaciousness doesn't need any permission from form to be. Okay, not at all. It's the opposite. Form arises in pure spaciousness. Pure spaciousness gives form the opportunity to arise. It's not form that's giving pure spaciousness the opportunity to arise. But that's the belief that we're used to. So we have to practice turning that around. That's why we say, this is now. This is now. This camera is now. Okay? This tree is now. And you can say that, you know, that mountain, or it's better to say this mountain is now. But you can say that mountain is now. But there's more immediacy, I think, if you say this. This mountain space is now. This mountain space is now. Or you can say, mountain space is now. Tree space is now. Dirt space is now. Rock space is now. Ocean space is now. Water space is now. Water space is now. Water as it is. When you say as it is, means that it's already abiding in pure spaciousness. That's as it is. Okay, there's already the case. It's already as it is. Everything as it is. Universe as it is. So this is, again, the alchemy of ascension. Absolutely. Very simple, isn't it? And yet, to those who are not prepared for it, they say, "Wow, I can't embrace it." Well, that's why I say that. We have to work every day, work as much as we can, because we have to get to the point where this feels self-evident. You know, it feels right. Sometimes there's an intuitive acceptance. There's an intuitive acceptance of it. atmosphere as it is. This atmosphere is now. Atmosphere is now. Sky is now. Mountain space is now. Forest space is now. Animal space is now. People space is now. Building space is now. River space is now. Insect space is now. Plant space is now. Plant space as it is. Plant space as it is. This is what we're doing, is where the mind is waking up, remembering what the true condition of reality is by making these affirmations. But I would say, first, I've been telling people, got to use this continuity thing. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. Otherwise, it's going to be, I think it's probably too difficult. You have to start somewhere and say, I don't have a physical problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a physicality problem, I have a continuity problem. And once you then start valuing the resolution to the continuity problem, then you'll get this alchemy of ascension, where you practice basically declaring that pure spaciousness is primary, you see. So, this day is now. This year is now. This century is now. This millennium is now. This epoch is now. This civilization is now. Civilization as it is. Civilization as it is. Time as it is. Time is now. This time is now. Time is now. Time as it is. And the intellect will say, well, what do you mean? Where are you going with this? It is simply a statement of fact, that's all. So it doesn't need to go anywhere. It is just reminding ourselves that it's pure spaciousness that's primary. It doesn't need any permission from time to be what it is, to establish itself. No, time is a decoration with arising within the pure spaciousness that is now, that is. And so that's what we're reminding ourselves. But it's in a practice format, which is very powerful, right? This table is now. This desk is now. This chair is now. This chair is now. Meaning it's just really, it's just pure spaciousness. And certainly the form is abiding in pure spaciousness. It is now. This chair is now. There's nowhere else it could ever be. This chair is now. It's always abiding in the pure spaciousness. It's always, therefore, now. This is a powerful, powerful technique. Now, I almost had a Michael Schumacher moment just about an hour ago. I was hurrying to wrap up my work for the day, and I was going to a house to pick some heavy load up from a house, a very nice fancy house, and a very steep driveway. Very steep driveway in the house. And the people go around and throw magazines, fancy magazines on the driveway, well, once every 2 weeks or something, once a month or whatever. And it happened to be the day they threw this magazine. It was on the slope of a very steep driveway. And I was carrying this heavy load. And it was blocking my view. And wouldn't you know that my foot stepped right on the magazine. This is the magazine that they throw. Gentry, you know. All about the nouveau riche celebrating themselves. And what was terrible about it was, actually, it's two magazines, and this is the other one called Wealth. And it's stacked one magazine on top of the other. So what happened was, my foot landed right on the top magazine on this, and it slipped off of the bottom magazine, ripping this plastic. And of course, I had a heavy load and I was going downhill, and suddenly my left foot completely slips out as the magazine slips. And it was a miracle that I didn't get hurt. Fortunately, I escaped injury. But it could have easily gone the other way, for sure, for sure. So it was a great blessing that I escaped injury. I've had a lot of close calls, actually. and this was one of them. So something is looking out for us. When we are working on the spiritual path, something looks out for it. Now, why did I step there in the first place? Well, because something also is trying to get us injured, actually. Most definitely. Trying to get us our inattention, trying to get us in the bad spot. It was just like a horrible setup, really. Horrible setup. And I have found in life that there is this sort of a self-destructive intelligence that works to undermine us and tear us down, especially if we're trying to get free. And so I put my foot in the worst possible place and skated through it very fortunately. Unfortunately, Schumacher did not. And now, the question is, to use Schumacher as sort of a topic, which is a very interesting topic, I find, actually. A very symbolic, heavily symbolic topic. The question is, can he get better? And the answer is absolutely. And people say, well, if we pray for him, he'll get better. Well, that is, if prayer is in the right way, he can. The dead can be raised if you pray in the right way. You can say, you know, this coma is now. This coma is now. This coma as it is. This coma as it is. This coma is now. So where is there a coma in pure spaciousness? Is pure spaciousness in a coma? No, it's not. No, it's not. You can say this death is now. I don't have a coma problem. I have a continuity problem. This coma is now. This coma as it is. This coma as it is. That literally can heal. Absolutely. So those people who are in comas, those people, you know, can be healed and come out of it. Absolutely they can. There's no coma in pure spaciousness, and we are pure spaciousness. Everything is pure spaciousness, as a matter of fact. So if you just abide in the nature of pure pure spaciousness, this world as it is, this world as it is, that presence absolutely can bring someone out of a coma, and they will, you know, can bring about miracles, what we call miracles. Absolutely. From our standpoint, from the upside down standpoint, it's like miracles, but it's not a miracle, it's just simply as it is. As it is. Everything as it is. Everything is now. Everything is now. Everything as it is. Now, yesterday, none of this would make any sense to me. Really. I'd say, there's that gobbledygook, you know, spiritual, non-dual, what are they talking about? What are they talking about? But today it makes total sense. I mean, I totally get it. Now, what's responsible for that? All the effort, all the effort, all the effort. And no doubt, some top-notch gurus have been helping. No doubt about it. Because this is top-notch stuff. This is the alchemy of ascension. This is core key stuff that's being shared right here. This doesn't come from anything other than you know, the top totally realized gurus. This is totally potent technique right now. This is now. This is now. Some gurus say suchness. That suchness, just suchness. One word, suchness. And if you're ready, you can actually be enlightened to hear that. This is now. And for the one who's ready, they just suddenly totally get it, totally. Whereas before they didn't get it at all. So what I'm saying to everyone here is, don't worry if you don't get it, because I didn't get it before today. But if you keep practicing, you will get it. You will get it. And I say the continuity issue is key. You have to insist on that you have a continuity problem. Otherwise, the ego will have leverage over you and will put distortions in your mind, and you won't get it. You will not get it. Getting this is very high attainment, actually. So you don't get that until you are, you know, if the ego has leverage over you, you won't get it. You won't get it. So this is just proof that using this continuity technique removes the leverage of the ego. Otherwise, I wouldn't have gotten it. Wouldn't have gotten it. So use that continuity technique. Be very proficient at it. You know, just try it for a day, for a week, and just keep working at it. Keep working at it. We'll keep bringing that up. That's the root. That's the root practice. Continuity problem. I have only one problem. I have a continuity problem. That's the only problem that I have. You say, I have a continuity problem, and that's the only problem that I have. See, this is a super important declaration that opens the door then for direct declarations of spaciousness. This is now. This is now. Time is now. Time is now. Space is now. Space is now. Space is now. The space that we see is not pure spaciousness at all. No, it's not. It's space. So space is now. Cosmos is now. Universe is now. World is now. Country is now. State is now. I am now. Okay? I am now. I as it is. I as it is. Car as it is. Street as it is. House as it is. Telephone pole as it is. Bird as it is. This bird is now. Bird as it is. Cloud as it is. Cloud space as it is. Meaning many clouds. Cloud space. You know, there's a bunch of clouds in space. Cloud space. Call it. Tree space. Cloud space. Water space. Mountain space. Shrubbery space. Shrubbery space as it is. Time is now. And I don't have a time problem. I have a continuity problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem that I have. I don't have a time problem. I have a continuity problem. This is the key practice. It's like being able to dribble a basketball. You can't play basketball unless you dribble. You can't shoot, you know, play the game unless you dribble. And shooting comes from your ability to dribble up and down the court and get in position to shoot and have fun. But first you have to learn how to dribble. I remember I was always a stickler for the fundamentals of anything, like making sure you do the fundamentals extremely well. Like for instance, basketball, dribble. Oh my God, practice dribbling. Both hands equally well, behind my back, between my legs, fast, slow. I could dribble any which way imaginable. And then that enabled me to just zigzag all over the court. You know, it's fundamentals is important. Fundamentals are super important. Don't overlook the fundamentals. Nail them, you know, just really, really put your effort into the fundamentals. And the other stuff comes easy. The other stuff comes easy. And the ego says, you're so talented, you don't need to worry about the fundamentals. Yes, you do. Absolutely. The more talented you are, the more you'll sweat the fundamentals. Because it takes real talent to do that, right? It takes humility, mood of repentance to sweat the fundamentals. This day is now. This time is now. This year is now. This society is now. This society as it is. This society as it is. This month as it is. This week as it is. This feeling as it is. This feeling is now. This feeling is now. This breath is now. This heartbeat is now. This heartbeat as it is. This heartbeat is now. I don't have a heart problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a physicality problem. I have a continuity problem. A lot of people have very bad, strong troubles right now. Anxiety, depression is epidemic, actually. Way more than we realize. And many people will know others who are struggling with anxiety and depression. And it's super important to recognize the seriousness of this and to recognize how it has to be healed. And the only way to really heal it is to get the right relationship accept right relationship again between a spaciousness and decorations and spaciousness, what we call form or energy. Again, it doesn't matter to pure spaciousness what the dance is, and it has no effect on pure spaciousness. So, just one minute, please. Now, a lot of people are maxed out on their medicines, and it's still not effective. And we live in a crisis. Actually, in Scripture, it tells us that the end times will be characterized by a pharmaceutical society. We live in a pharmaceutical society. Most content you get in the world is actually supported by the advertising dollars of Big Pharma. Okay, most what you're getting in the world, and their whole purpose is to make you think that you don't have a continuity problem, you have a physical problem, you have a health problem, and their remedy, of course, is the pills that they sell you. So there's an enormous vested interest in maintaining the status quo on that level. And so we are in a pharmaceutical society, pharmaceutical world. And this is the trouble. This is an extreme crisis. You max out on your medicines and they stop working. The antibiotics stop working, right? The antidepressants stop working, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. You get tolerance to them. They don't really cure the situation anyway. And then where are you? You're a creek without a paddle. So having been through the entire situation of anxiety and depression and every kind of insecure mental state imaginable, and having worked through it and seen exactly what the root of it all is, et cetera, I have the utmost compassion for people suffering in such a manner. It is truly a horrific trial. And there's nothing funny about it. It's very serious. Because it seems like you're never going to get out of it. You're just lost. Lost in space. I don't have a space problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a depression problem, I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. This is the root practice that anyone can do who's anxious, depressed. I don't have an anxiety problem, I have a continuity problem. This is the fastest, directest route to get out of it. And then when your thoughts start complaining too much about something, say, no, there's no value in those thoughts. There's no value in that train of thought at all. Only the vision of oneness has value. That is true, because it reminds us of reality. Only the vision of oneness has value. That's another key technique, okay? Only the vision of oneness has value. The vision of oneness is the only value there is. It's the only way we're reminded of reality, which is the only way to solve the continuity problem. The only way. The only way is to be reminded of reality. And the vision of oneness, this oneness, this is nowness. This is nowness is essentially the vision of oneness. This is nowness. This is nowness. Meaning, you know, totality. I mean, this is nowness. This is nowness. You can say this tree, you've got to practice specifically. This walkway is now. This walkway is now. And again, to the intellect, they'll say you're wasting your time. Wasting your time. But to the inner being and awareness, the inner being awareness is saying, oh, yeah, now you got it. Now you got it. Now you're talking my talk. Now you're talking my talk. Finally, you're talking my talk. It understands this perfectly well. There's something inside you that understands this talk perfectly well. This evening is now. This evening as it is. This evening as it is. No value in train of thoughts start to rise. Oh yeah, what about this? No value there. Only value is in the vision of oneness. This is now. This is now. So you wonder why, I always wondered why some of the top gurus said such funny stuff. I said, how come you can't explain it to us? What's the problem? Why do you say, you know, I am that or something or, you know, whatever. It's the language of spaciousness. And we have to learn to use our language that way, our concepts that way. Turn the mind around. You know, continuity issue. you have to prep for the resolution to it by turning your attention, turning your valuing to where the answer actually is. This is now. This is now. Now, there's nothing intellectual I'm getting from that, but it's kind of like resonating at a deep level, not an intellectual level. So don't worry, there's no explanation at the intellectual level. I mean, I can try to explain it intellectually, but it'll just get you bogged down, actually. It's better to just try and practice it and say, well, I'm not getting anything out of it intellectually. Don't worry about that. The answer doesn't come at that level. It doesn't originate from that level. It doesn't originate. It smooths it out, but it doesn't originate there. So, see, this is now. Intellect is now. Emotion is now. Intellect is now. Instinct is now. Consciousness is now. Consciousness as it is. Consciousness as it is. Remember, you have to practice it. You're the one who has to be the guru. Each one of us has to be the guru, actually. It doesn't help. It's not going to get the job done if you just, oh, I went to see a guru and the guru said all this amazing stuff and that was really cool. So that's enough. No, that's not enough. You have to actually practice it. This is now. This is now. Guru is now. Savior is now. Guru as it is. Guru as it is. Due to some changes in the living situation, one of our cats got kicked outside. So the cat is here now, just hanging out with me. I didn't kick it out. Very good cat. It's to its benefit, isn't it? It's not in a nice cozy place with a television going or something, but it is here with this vibe here. This is now. The this is now vibe. This is now. And don't worry to put it in some form like the intellect says, oh, now I get it. Yeah, like Richard Albert said, be here now or something. No, don't do that. Don't do that. See, there's no value there. No value there. No. This is now. Right where we are. This table is now. This floor is now. This seat is now. This food is now. This food as it is. This food as it is. Food as it is. Drink as it is. Sleep as it is. Waking as it is. Space as it is. Insist on that. Insist. It's an insistence. You're insisting on it. Listening as it is. This listening is now. This listening is now. This presence is now. This body is now. This awareness is now. Awareness as it is. This awareness is now. I don't have an awareness problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a consciousness problem. I have a continuity problem. And the continuity problem is the only problem that I have. I only have one problem, and it's the continuity problem, and I accept it. Absolutely accept it. This speech is now. Speech as it is. This time. Time is now. This time is now. Time is now. Space is now. Ocean is now. Sky is now. World is now. Dirt is now. Rocks. Rock is now. Rock space is now. Rockiness is now. Treeness is now. You can add a ness to it. Treeness is now. Rockness is now. Rock as it is. Rock space as it is. Dirt as it is. It's a very powerful one. Dirt as it is. Because we think dirt somehow displaces pure spaciousness. So it's very important. We think of pure spaciousness as like space, and then think it space ends where the dirt is. Not true at all. Dirt is now. Concrete is now. Asphalt is now. Stone is now. Stone space is now. Stone as it is. Rock as it is. Dirt as it is. All right? very key, concrete as it is. Concrete is now. Concrete is now. Steel is now. Iron is now. Titanium is now. Diamond is now. Diamondness is now. Diamond as it is. Ruby as it is. Sapphire as it is. Gold as it is. Gold is now. Gold is now. Gold is now. We tend to think of gold as being some kind of root thing, right? And that nothing can get into gold. Gold is now. It's abiding in everywhereness, exactly the same as everything. Every other decoration is abiding in everywhereness. Zero dimensionality, pure spaciousness, pure consciousness, pure awareness, pure being. Gold is now. Vacuum is now. Emptiness is now. Even emptiness is abiding in pure emptiness, right? As we think of vacuum or something, we think it's, there's nothing there, it's emptiness. No, emptiness is now. Emptiness as it is. Fullness as it is. Partialness as it is. Surplus as it is. Surplus is now. Famine as it is. Famine is now. Sickness is now. Coma is now. Coma as it is. Coma as it is. Maybe the world should practice trying to help Schumacher wake up. Is, you know, why not? He's a brother in spirit just like all of us, brother and sister in spirit. Spirit like all of us. Same truth, same abidance. High profile. Coma is now. Coma as it is. Coma as it is. You don't have to name anything. You can just focus on this particular coma as it is. Maybe a lot of people with comas will wake up. Possible. Death as it is. Death is now. Death is now. The idea of the dead rising from the grave is maybe based on this. I'm not one who's particularly believes in the idea of all those who've been cremated and all those who are skeletal, etc., will suddenly reform physically and rise from the dead. It's possible. Sure, it's possible. If it happens, it happens. Absolutely, but it's more, you know, it's more likely we're simply pointing to the fact for us here who are identifying with these bodies, etc. So we don't ever have to identify with again. We're healing our perception. We're healing our mind. We're turning in the right direction. Death is now. Death as it is. Death as it is. Death is now. Death is now. Sickness is now. Coma is now. Sickness is now. Sickness as it is. Cancer is now. Cancer as it is. And I guarantee you that the ones who have truly accepted this perfectly, absolutely people get healed around them. They drop their insistence that cancer, you know, isn't or something. that cancer is primary and the spaciousness is had need this permission. It's a reflection of that insanity. But if you say cancer is now, and you have this presence of cancer is now, everything, this is now, this is now. Just whatever it is that's disagreeing with that comes into alignment. You come into alignment, and the cancer is, you know, just, it's gone. The perfect purity of pure spaciousness. The attempt to reverse it is let go of, evaporates, dissolves, cancer disappears. As I pointed out before in other videos, that the Sri Anandamayi had quite many types of illnesses, and they would get very bad, and then suddenly they just vanish very quickly, sometimes instantaneously. And she said, I allow these forms to come play with me and have darshan, and then when it's over, they leave. Interesting perspective. But it shows that the perfect awareness of this is now. I think I'm gonna reverse it. So cancer is now. Okay. Cancer as it is. Cancer as it is. You're stating the correct relationship between form, between God and decoration, which is really just pure spaciousness, but we see it at this point with decoration. Accepting the correct relationship there actually removes the motive for that, and we say, I don't have a cancer problem, I have a continuity problem. So if you don't have a cancer problem, where's the cancer? Gone. Gone. Where's the coma? Gone. I don't have a coma problem, I have a continuity problem. So coma as it is, coma is now, is meaning it's pure spaciousness. That's right now. And everything in pure spaciousness is perfectly supported, perfectly within pure spaciousness. There isn't any problem. There's no problematic nature whatsoever. And you can follow this down the rabbit hole, but don't. There's no value in that. There's only value in the vision of oneness. That's the only value there is. I'm just pointing out that most definitely illnesses can vanish, since problems can vanish. That's not enlightenment, but certainly problems can vanish. Like they said, Jesus just walked among people and their problems just disappeared. It absolutely can happen. He even said that we will do the same things at some point too. Because absolutely, there's nothing to it, because it's simply, this leprosy is now. This leprosy as it is. This leprosy is now. It is now. Leprosy is now. It's not separate from the now. It's completely abiding in the now. Right now. Right now. So what's the problem with the now? Is there some problem for now? No, there's not. We are the now. Now is all that there is. Pure spaciousness is all that there is. God is all that there is. So it's just another decoration. And you can, again, follow that up. At some point we might, but it's not important now. Don't to say it has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. That's a fact. Only the vision of oneness has value. But it could be interesting as a point of practice to look at the coma thing. I think comas are like kind of on the front burner for some reason, because actually the whole world's in a deep coma. So we're all Michael Schumacher, actually. We're all in a severe, incredible vegetative state, severe coma vegetative state. That actually, that's very fact. I mean, as far as delusion goes, it's stating a pragmatic fact. It's not a fact about reality, but it is correct to say that we're entertaining a severely delusional belief system. That's a correct statement. So it's correct to say we're in a severe, severe coma, a deep coma of forgetfulness, a vegetative state. But hey, vegetative state is now. Vegetative state as it is. I don't have a vegetative state problem, I have a continuity problem. And the only value there is the vision of oneness. That's the only value there is. So, we can practice on the coma thing. Coma is now. Coma is now. Coma as it is. Vegetative state as it is. Vegetative state is now. I talked to somebody, chance meeting is just hard to explain how it happened, but it did. Somebody who actually works in a coma hospital where all the patients are in a coma. And I talked to him about it, and he explained, what it's all about, etc. He said, there are people been in there 30 years. So, what? Yeah, they keep them alive in a vegetative state. Now, vegetative state is not a brain dead state. There was this girl in Oakland, California, who was brain dead, and the parents refused to have her taken off life support, and finally they had her moved somewhere. I don't know what happened to her. I haven't been following the news. I really don't. But it was deteriorating very badly because she was brain dead. Okay. But the vegetative state is different. Of course, brain death is now. Brain dead is now. Brain death as it is. Brain death as it is. Okay. Vegetative state is different in that the breathing, you know, the basic, real rudimentary, they call it vegetative, because like a plant, you can't move, you can't talk, you can't do anything, but you're still growing, the hair grows, the fingernails grow, you breathe, and there's you know, just a sort of a real baseline kind of existence there, vegetative state. So vegetative states can last, they can keep them alive for a long, long time. And I said that sometimes they wake up, they say, well, you know, people hope that they can, and said sometimes they do. I talked to this person who's been working as a nurse in a coma hospital, long-term care coma hospital, and sometimes they do wake up, he said. Sometimes they do get better. Sometimes they get better. Sometimes it takes years, he actually said. Sometimes after years, they will come out of the coma. Yeah. And you don't know what the what's going on. There's a spiritual teacher, well, Mario Mantisi or something like that, who used to play for a rock band of the 70s or something. Ooh, I can't remember the rock band's name, but it was pretty well known, actually. I don't know, was it the Commodores or something, but he was the bass player, and he's actually kind of an amazing guru right now. He was severely assaulted and stabbed and was in a hospital, was in a coma for a long time, and he came out of it. And during that coma, he had these incredible spiritual experiences, actually, which he feels healed him. And he came out with some sort of cosmic awareness, universal awareness or something. He's a very unique person, to say the least. And this amazing story. He said before, he wasn't that way at all. He wasn't that way at all. And he underwent this random, he was just randomly attacked, I think, somewhere over in London or something, I believe. Just horrible, just what happened to him. And he was dead many times. He went into a death state, you know, they revived him. And he went through this just incredible saga of near-death experiences and coma, etc. And came out of it, totally different mindset, with some kind of universal awareness and understanding. I don't suggest that for anybody, but you know, it takes all kinds, doesn't it? Takes all kinds. We're not looking for that, though. We're not looking for that approach. This is the Yani approach. This is the Raja Yoga approach. This is the clarity approach. This is the reason approach. This is the approach of the safe, I call it the safe approach, the safe way approach. We go at it very clearly, and we see very clearly what we're doing as much as possible. And we're not looking for anything dramatic. We're not looking for a near-death experience or any of that kind of stuff. But though, for some reason, those kinds of circumstances do happen. They do happen. Now, Schumacher may wake up, and he may be a very different person. He may wake up a guru. That is possible, actually. That would be very interesting, wouldn't it? Be very interesting indeed. Completely forgotten about his previous lives. Has nothing to do with anything. I'm a completely different consciousness now. Coma is now. Coma as it is. Vegetative state is now. Vegetative state as it is. World as it is. And again, I've listened my whole life to this stuff and I didn't understand it. But suddenly this morning I understood it. And nothing happened really, except I just kept making extreme efforts. And what happened really was I had this intuition that I better not watch the Super Bowl. It's going to be decisive. It's now is not the time to be watching the Super Bowl, because it's going to put you into a deeper, deeper coma, and you're going to miss your opportunity because you're ripe. The fruit is ripe. You don't want to watch it. So I didn't watch it. Didn't pay no attention. Never even thought about it. You know, it just kept focus on what I was focusing on. Then the big breakthrough happened. So follow your intuition, and as much as possible, avoid those situations that are designed to bring you into a deeper state of coma, okay? Avoid the dance halls, avoid the bars, avoid the parties, avoid the this, that activity, all this kind of stuff, you know? And there's a lot of people in the world who are actually trying to bring everybody into the deepest coma possible. And they might seem very attractive to you. They might have some kind of physical attractiveness or charm or spell. And they may use drugs on you. They may use all sorts of, you know, perfumes and drugs and drink and dancing and all this kind of stuff. Male and female. I'm talking both ways here. Stay away from that. Stay away. Oftentimes, the people who are trying to drag you down the worst have this sort of superficial physical charm. You feel kind of like physically attracted or charmed by them. But it's hiding. That's the way they hide a facade. You know, the nature is very nasty, isn't it? That oftentimes all this beautiful surface stuff hides a very poisonous sting or something, right? The spiders have all this colorful marking, and all the fish. It's amazing how nature uses superficial attractiveness to hide, you know, vicious predatoriness. So, stay away from superficial attractiveness like that. For sure. Don't trust it. Don't trust it. And I guarantee you, everybody is going to run across that. It's all over the place. All over the place. And you just say, no value in this. No value in this. No value. No value. Is this, you say, is this the vision of oneness? No? Then there's no value. No value to it. No value to it. Now, intuitively, you know what you're talking about. All right? But you have to insist, no value here. There's no value. And then just stay away now. No interest, no value. No value, no interest. Goodbye. And when you do that, you'll be amazed at the kind of breakthroughs you have. Breakthroughs come because you made smart choices. You're not going to have breakthroughs if you indulge in comatose behavior. Okay, you're not. As nice as the drugs are, the pot and all the various ecstasy and DMT, whatever, all that kind of stuff. There's so many designer drugs now, it's ridiculous. There's probably thousands of various variations and more on the way. As nice as those are, okay, they do put you into a deeper coma, actually. And you're not going to get the breakthroughs that you need doing that. It's kind of like you're in a coma and you don't care. The drugs sort of say, well, yeah, I know I'm in a deep coma, but it's okay. Yeah, I feel bummed out that I'm in a coma, but I can use drugs and I won't feel so bad about it. I remember somebody said that they don't drink so that they're more interesting. They drink to make other people more interesting to them because they feel that they're so bored by the world. The world's just so boring. They drink and then the world seems more interesting, okay? But it doesn't bring you out of the coma at all, not at all. And it builds up tolerance. You get dragged down so severely. It's this world is just the nastiest place, really. It's so many great people have been drugged down by bad habits. You know, it gets all of us really, one time or another. The world is gunning for us, absolutely, for everyone, absolutely. It's a cruddy place, you know, cruel, raw, utter deception. Cruel, raw, utter deception here. And so you have to say, no value, no value. I have only one problem. This, identify, I don't have a party problem. I have a continuity problem. Therefore, I'm not going to spend any time at parties. A lot of people go to parties, do things just to kind of see, oh, what kind of problem is this? What is this problem like? You know, let me see what this, let me try this on. Say, no, I don't have a drug problem. I have a continuity problem. So I got to focus all my valuing on the solution of the continuity problem. See that? It focuses your valuing on when you say, I only have one problem. Well, that's pretty important. If you realize you only have one problem, you say, hey, I'm really close to liberation, right, from suffering. Very close. So why the heck am I going to bother with all this other stuff, which is problematical? And I just said, I don't have those problems. I only have one problem. So you're going to then focus on that one problem for sure. For sure. Once you realize you only have one problem, you're going to say, hey, I'm going to solve this one. And then I'm done. I am done with all this stuff. Absolutely. Every person using drugs, eventually you're going to recognize somebody who's going to be desperately trying to get off drugs. That is for a fact. Okay. And also we say, those beautiful sirens, those glamorous people, you know, for every wonderfully glamorous, physically attractive person, there's someone out in the world who never wants to see him again. That's a fact. That is a fact. You can, you know, you've come across this from using the example, like a very beautiful, attractive woman, you know, just everybody says, oh my gosh, she's incredible. Well, they're talked to her ex-boyfriend, okay? Never wants to see her again, guaranteed. Says, whoa, it's trouble, stay away from that. Believe me, stay away from that. And and it gets the other way too, so even the male, same sort of thing, right? Same sort of thing. For every, you know, really handsome, incredible hunk male, you know, all the women looking, wow, it's incredible. There's some woman that says, I never want to see him again. Guaranteed, never. Stay away from that. Stay away from that. You don't want those problems. You want the continuity problem. You want the, and you've got it. You already have it. You already have the continuity problem. So say, I don't have an attraction problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. Free, get, fix that problem, so resolve that problem. No more problems ever. No more problems ever. Because what it does is it, the resolution of it helps us remember the correct relationship of reality, the true relationship of reality, right? Whereas now we got it backwards. We're trying to pretend that we can reverse the direction of creation. That's what we're pretending. So it's very cool that we have some teachers from the past that are here now helping us, actually. That's very, very cool. The import of that is just, I don't know. It's just incredible. That you know, we're cared enough about that there are those who are, you know, helping us, are helping us. We don't see them, but they work on the subtle levels. And maybe they don't want to be seen because we'll reify them, meaning we'll concretize and try to worship them, and, you know, which is not right. Because they're getting us to say, this is now, you know, Guru is now. That's what's important. Not worshiping the Guru, but Guru is now. Guru as it is. Guru as it is. Go to Satsang, say, Satsang as it is. Satsang is now. This Satsang is now. Satsang is now. Satsang as it is. Satsang as it is. You can say, Muji as it is. Muji as it is. Muji is now. Muji is now. Muji as it is. Eckhart Tolle, Eckhart as it is. Eckhart is now. Eckhart is now. Same thing with anybody. You can say the present. Obama is now. Obama as it is. Obama as it is. Obama is now. Okay? I am now. I as it is. Mountain is now. Mountain as it is. Pope Francis as it is. Pope as it is. Pope is now. Pope is now. Pope is now. Religion is now. Atheism is now. Okay? But don't make any exception. It's all that this is now. Totality. Oneness is now. Oneness is now. Oneness as it is. Oneness as it is. Oneness is now. So you might say, wow, I'm tired, I can't practice. Well, I guarantee you, before I did this video, I was completely exhausted. Usually I am very exhausted because this effort is very intense. But absolutely you can do it. It's important. It's very important. Very important, because remember, we're all in a coma. And we got to come out of that coma. They're trying to get Schumacher out of the coma by reducing the level of barbiturates gradually, slowly, tapering off the barbiturates, tapering. Just like QE3 is going to be tapering off the amount of buying that the Fed does. Try to come out of this economic coma. Again, economic coma is now. Economic coma as it is. Economics is now. Economics as it is. Right? Very important. Economic situation is now. Economics is now. Stock market is now. Stock market as it is. Stock market as it is. Prepare in this way. And when the crisis comes, you'll be amazed that somehow it doesn't touch you. Because you're somehow in tune with what is. And this is now. All this is, as it is, as it is, as it is, as it is. And as it is as it is, not needing permission to be as it is. So you're saying, as it is, you're giving back the permission you tried to steal. We tried to steal reality, you know, from God, and now we're giving it back. We're saying, well, we never got it, but we're letting go of our clutch, trying to grab a hold of it. We're letting go of the effort to steal it, really. You can't steal reality. How can you steal everywhereness? Where can you place it? Where can you put it so that it's stolen? Everywhereness. How can you steal everywhereness? How's that possible? That's funny. That is really funny. Ah, yeah, we're gonna steal everywhereness. That's what we've been trying to do, is to steal everywhereness. So, everywhereness as it is. Everywhereness as it is. Yeah. Stealing as it is. Stealing is now. Stealing is now. Right? Theft is now. Criminality is now. Criminality as it is. War as it is. War is now. War as it is. Now, fact is, how in the world could we be at a place where we're able to talk this way? It's amazing, right? Because of the great teachers that have come in the world, for sure. And the great, great boost and help we've gotten from many, many, many different teachers. There have been many who have realized this, all right? There have been many throughout history who have had the continuity problem resolved for them. And some very, very great teachers have come into the world with the presence of this is now. This is now. Just that, this is now. And that helps us. It absolutely helps us. Otherwise, we could not get to this point. No way. Look, how can someone's in an extremely deep coma, how can they, you know, don't they need doctors to help them come out of the coma? Yeah, absolutely. And they do. So the doctors are helping us, you know, actually the spiritual doctors are helping us come out of our spiritual coma. For sure they are. Absolutely. And Longchamp is one of the head surgeons. You know, maybe he's in charge of me coming out of my coma. I don't know. He's part of the team, though. Maybe there's a whole team, actually. A lot of times there's a team of doctors, you know, who are helping bring someone out of a coma. So, but we're fortunate. We do have those doctors, actually, spiritual doctors. Now I may be like partially out of the coma, but I'm just babbling, you know. Like you're sitting there, coming out of anesthesia, and blah blah blah. I know people. I've never been under anesthesia, but I've seen people that have been. They come out of it, and yeah, they're talk, and they can't remember what they said. They're kind of like, yeah, not so much. Did I say that? Yeah, so there's a time when they kind of, you know, the twilight state, where they can talk and visit, but they're not completely connected to what's going on. So maybe I'm in that kind of condition where I'm in that twilight state where I'm almost awake, but I'm just kind of groggy still, coming out of that deep coma. Coma is now. Coma is now. Now, I know a lot of people praying for Schumacher, you know, they say, please, 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 we need you here, you know, and don't leave us. You can win. You can win this final battle, all this kind of stuff. You know, that's the kind of traditional prayer that people in comas use. Okay, but those who are not in comas don't use that type of prayer. They make declarations of truth. Coma is now. Pure and simple. No two ways about it. Coma is now. Coma as it is. As it is. Now you hold that thought, coma as it is. You can hold like Schumacher in your mind or something, or whoever. You know, you may have somebody that you know, that you may say, well, let me see if this can be helpful or not. But don't overtry it. You know, don't overtry it really. Don't make a big effort. But it's just interesting to to use that and say, yeah, coma as it is. Coma as it is. Coma is now. Coma is now. Coma is now. Coma is now. Now, I have some sympathy for Germans. A lot of people don't. I had a previous life, I was a German. And so I do have affection for Germany and Germans. There's sort of a confidence about them, which is can be used in bad ways or good ways, actually. very daring. Germans can be very daring, very fearless, very resolute, very focused, very confident. You know, a lot of very positive qualities that Germans have, if they can be turned in the right direction. If they're turned in the wrong direction, we know what happens, right? Yeah, not good. But when they're turned in the right direction, like this life here is a result partially of the German life that I had, and of just being very, very determined and confident and disciplined. Very, very disciplined. And you know, using that discipline and confidence, you know, in the right way, and just very determined to succeed, you know, at any cost, refuse to fail. And take it very seriously. You know, the Germans are very serious, they take it very seriously. You know, I mean, they don't like to make mistakes or fail. I mean, they're really perfectionist. You know, the quality is very much perfectionist. And so that can be actually very helpful. So I do have a soft spot for Germans. Schumacher's a German. I have a soft spot. And so, you know, I hate to see that happen, what happened. It's a blow, you know, to the German pride. Like, wow, it's just like very sobering thing, very sobering. But that mentality does not understand the higher talk that we're talking here. Okay, it doesn't. It feels it can apply science and technology and medicine and intellect and stuff to solve, you know, all problems. Or, you know, high culture, high art, all this stuff, you know. No, that doesn't work. It doesn't work. So I had to get out of Germany, have a life here in America where I was able to get hold of Christian Science, New Thought, Course in Miracles, a lot of different teachings from the East, the Eastern teachers, all the different teachings. You know, Dzogchen, Radical Dzogchen, Buddhism, Advaita Vedanta, Zen, on and on and on and on and on. You know, non-dual, all the non-dual stuff, everything. And lead a life, a middle-class life of no accomplishment at all, where I could focus entirely on this. And somehow that was effective. has been effective, but again, this is now. Life is now, death is now, growth is now, age is now, aging is now, aging is now. Now the Germans would say, what are you talking about? Can you explain this to me, please? My intellect is very good. Can you please explain it to my intellect? I'm sure I can get it. There's nothing to get. It already is the case. That's what there is to get. It is already is the case. This is now. This is now. Time is now. Space is now. It's just, it's not a getting. It's a remembrance. It's not a getting, it's a remembrance. It's not something that we need to, some concatenation that we need to come up with, like a philosophy or something. No, this is just a pure statement of what is, what the facts of reality, remembrance of reality. It's just the dawning. It's just the dawning of reality. I mean, we don't need to make the sun rise, do we? I mean, the sun rises up its own accord and the dawn comes. We just have to open our eyes. That's all. It's just open our eyes. So, the sun is now. Sun is now. Sun as it is. Sunlight as it is. Sunlight as it is. Dawn as it is. Dawn is now. Dawn is now. All right. Very great. That is it for this one.